So, with the Willis Custom Airbrushing, they would do another cut. Already have a cut prepped up. Get my tape put in the middle. Now that keeps the overspray from getting inside the cut. Plus, when I go to sandblast this, it doesn't sandblast the interior. So, already got my designs laid out for what the customer wanted. I'm gonna skip through some of the process for the prep of the cup. If you wanna know the process for that, you can go back and look for the video that I painted this cup. It goes step by step all the way through. But with this one, I'm just gonna skip through till I get the base coat and start laying down stencils. So we'll go from there. All right, I went ahead and got my base coat put on and my metallic black. So now I'm gonna add the stencils to it and we'll go from there. We'll start my... All right. I got my stencils already weeded out. I'm gonna do something a little different on this cut. I usually do a break border between each side, but instead of that, I'm gonna use these lettering to go on each side. So these will break up each side and I'll have the designs on the other side. So what I'll do is go ahead and lay down the main sides, and I'm gonna spray, which covers up the black, and then I'm gonna spray some silver down here and place these on top of the silver. So first step is gonna be adding my stencil work. And again, like on the other cup, I usually put the logos, the cut that's raised on the sides, that way I have a nice clean surface on there. When we're doing these on the beveled edges, you'll see where it starts to warp the stencil. But we'll go back in and straighten all that stuff out here in a minute. Once I have everything laid out, I always start from the top and fold the transfer tape over. And just go straight down evenly, really slow, to make sure none of the stencil work comes back off the transfer paper. And when we get down to the beveled edge, that's when things will kind of want to be raised off. So again, I'm going slow, and just like this one. Do this too fast, you'll stretch the vinyl, then it won't lay back down straight. So just go slow, get your razor blade, help it out. Just keep on going. Alright. Now what I'm going to do is lay this out. I'm going to cut these places out to straighten them back up. And you'll lift them up. Get to the edge here. I'm going to cut this, lay it down, and just match it all back up. There we go. And be sure you press it down good, because if it doesn't, the stencil work is going to lift up, and when you start to spray, you'll start getting overspray underneath there. Underneath these little areas. So this is the very important part where you got to stretch them out. Just like that. All right, I'm going to come back to this side. I'm going to lift it up. I'm just pushing it back down until I get to a stopping point. It'll be this little area right here. So I'm going to take my razor blade and just cut it right there. Lay them down and try to match it back up. There we go. This little area. All right, now you can see where the stencil has overlapped right here. So all I do is just cut that little area out, which is straighten it back out. Remove it, and it's back to where it needs to be. Last little place is going to be this little area right here. So what I'll do, I'll start from one side, lifting up, and just pressing down. All the way to this edge right here. I'm going to go ahead and cut it off where it goes into the design. Lifting up. And that should be good enough. And all I'll do is just push it back down and it's all flat. A lot of people are scared to go below the bevel because it does warp. It just takes some extra time fixing the decal or the stencil. So now, with the lettering, I'm going to do some silver down here too, right there. Because I'm going to put this stencil down here. So now I'm going to come back to this side. Alright, flags are going to be really tricky because everything's so straight. But again, just like we did on the other side, I'm going to lay everything down and do some cutting where we need to cut. So, I'm going to play this down. I'll move the camera away so you can look, it'd be easier to see. I got it pretty much laid around. So on these numbers, I always start in the middle and try to get them flat. Because all the lines, I always cut it out later to straighten them out. But I really want to get the numbers right. See, this is starting to flare out. But once I get the transfer paper over, I can move it back over. So, we'll flip back this way. You can see this area right here is starting to come off. I was laying back down. Just press it down a little bit further. All right. There we go. Alright, now when you get to your beveled edge, you're going to slow down. You got this little area right here. Alright. Now I got everything. You see everything's starting to warp there. So we're going to tear this all away and straighten it all up. Even though the number changed, what I'll do is just cut the file a little bit. Just like so. Alright, this looks pretty straight here. I'm gonna lay this back down. In my areas where it gets close together, you just trim away a little bit. Be sure not to cut down too hard, because it'll go into the paint and you don't want that to happen. Now you can see where this line right here and this line right here is spread apart. So I'm going to peel them both away and then lay them back down as straight as I can. Yeah, still, it just takes time. This one, I'll peel all the way off. Start over. Yeah. since we got all the black done, I'm gonna add this little, I'm gonna do silver on all these. So I'm just gonna spray some silver where I'm just gonna put the letters, and then I'll lay down my stencil work back down, and then come back and spray some black. All right, what I did was went ahead and sprayed my silver, just on the edges. I didn't have to spray the whole thing, because I want to go with a darker tint through the whole thing. All right, now the thing's dry. I'm gonna lay down my stencil work. Also on this, you can take a Scotch-Brite pad or some steel wool or something, and you can rough this up to give it more of a grunge effect. But you can also just come back and do it with some black, and I can show you that later. For now, I'm going to get this one side cut. Again, slow down at the bevel. And on this raised logo, the vinyl is going to go over that. So I just push it down with my thumb and make sure it's all covered. Right, now do the other side. Just like so. Right now for this little ring down here, if you look, you can see that the stencil is lifted up on that seam. So what I do is I take my little squeegee and I press it down in there so it makes sure that it sticks it real well, and you won't have to worry about overspray underneath there. Now this cup is going to have a grunge feel to it. You know, everything's going to be just kind of tattered and battle worn, so they call. So I don't really care that my stencil work is off because it's just thrown on there. If I was going to do a cleaner version, of course I would straighten everything up. You know, like these areas that are close to the stencil, it doesn't matter. Now that I got my stencil work put on over the top of silver, I'm going to go back with my black diamond mist, and I'm going to spray over the silver to bring back the black. Alright, I got my black put on. Now, just like this sprayed just like the rest of the cup was. Now we're going to start getting into detail. There's going to be a lot of colors added. This customer wants the base or the whole thing to be blue. So I'm going to add some different types of candy blues. All of my paints are from Custom Shop. They're all automotive paints. Again, they're good. Be placing in the dishwasher. Think of your cup is just like your car. You know, you can go to the car wash. Same concept here. My electric blue is a little bit darker, and the Hawaiian blue is a little bit lighter. So I'm gonna go from there. Start adding paint. So just what we'll do first is I'll take my detail wipe. Always want to shake a paint set. Doesn't have to be perfect because this is my grunge cup, grunge concept. Alright, here's a good example. This little area right here, you can see that it's raised. I didn't get it pushed down good enough, so when I started to spray, now I'm going to have overspray in there. So I'll need to flatten it back out. But thankfully, again, this is going to be a grunge cup, so it really won't matter. But this is a good example. My coats. Before I put this cup back down, I'm going to dry this out some. I don't want to leave it on there too long because then my stencil will bubble up a little bit. Alright. Now, from here, I like to use these grunge stencils. You can find these on Amazon. Coast Airbrush. These are the grunge and texture stencils. So what we'll do is I'm going to come over here and start adding a little detail in there. And all this is random. Because you want it to look, you don't want patterns to something that's distressed or grunge. You just want to move your stencil around. Like I mentioned in my last video, be sure you wear some latex gloves or some kind of gloves around, because you don't want the oils off your fingers getting on the cup. If that happens, you won't, the paint won't stick to that area. So be sure you wear some kind of protecting gloves to keep all the oils off there. Now we got the first layer done. What I'll do, let me get these scars done, brighten them up. Now I'm gonna take my darker blue and I'm gonna spray the whole cup. And what this is gonna do is gonna, all that white will now be blue. Don't forget about your bottoms. I put my logos on the bottom of my cups. That way, when you sell your cups, your customer is always going to have this logo on the bottom to show off. Like, hey man, where'd you get that cup? From Wheels Custom Airbrushing. There's his logo. Go check him out. All right, so I'm going to go and spray my blue over the top of this, and we'll come back and I'll show you the results. All right, I got my dark blue sprayed on. Now we're going to do, once you spray a layer on, you need to spray your Mid-Coat Clear on top of your blue. What this does is it keeps that dark blue locked down, so when I start adding new colors, it won't affect, it won't saturate the new color. So in between every candy color, you need to lay down a Mid-Coat Clear. So now that I got the dark blue added, I'm going to come back with some white and add some more detail. Switch up my stencils, add some of this back there. The more layers of work you do, the more depth it creates. It gives you a more 3D effect on these different types of stencils. This stencil right here is awesome because you can add just multiple layers and it just creates more depth in there. It looks like you're looking down in there. that have been hovering around. Again, you're just gonna move this stuff around. There's no pattern to it. It's all random. Spray my lighter blue, my lighter Hawaiian, and I'll go ahead and add another makeup clear to that to seal the Hawaiian blue in, and then we'll come back and I'll show you the final result. Alright, I got the blue sprayed. You can tell it's a lighter blue. I got the clear coat or the makeup put on. So now I'm going to get some more white and I'm going to bring back the stars. Do some highlights around the stars and the letters. I'll probably do this in silver this time. That way it'll break it up. And after that, I gotta paint a blue line in the middle of this. So, what I'll do is I'm gonna use a brilliant silver. I use a titanium silver, which is a darker silver for under the numbers and letters. So now I'm gonna use the silver to bring everything out. Again, I'm just going to bring some of these out. Actually, I'm going to follow the edge of this. And this is just random. Because again, we're going for random. Too aggressive. I'm just spotting it here now. Thank you. pretty happy with this. I'm gonna bring some of this chlorine back out. Like it is. So now we're going to lay our blue line. What I do is take painter's tape. What I'm going to do is tape off this one straight line. All right, I'm going to cover this all white so it'll be brighter than the rest. Dry it off. It doesn't take long to dry off. You see when it does dry, because the shine will go away and it'll be flat. So that'll be all I need for that. So for the blue, I'm going to go with an intense blue pearl. The blue is going to be a lot lighter, and you'll see the difference when I pull it off. I'm going to go back to my white, and I'm just going to add a little bit here and there. I the back a little bit. Like so. Now I'm going to do this little area right here. Everything messed up. Taking the light. Square blue. From here, I pretty much like everything. I'm not going to add anything else to this. It looks pretty well where I want it to be. So from now, I'm going to remove all the stencil work, and when I'm done, we'll see the final result. All right, got all the stencil work taken off. Turned out pretty good. Next thing is, just go over everything, make sure we don't have any vinyl left on there. And I think I did find a piece right here. Doing these real detailed stuff that has a lot of little bitty stencil work on there, some vinyl left, you just gotta be careful that you don't leave it on there to clear over the cut, because you'll see the hump where that vinyl is. But if you do, it's no big deal, because it's all clear coated, it won't affect it. But everything looks good, no more issues out of it. Next step is the clear coat, and I'll put 3 coats of clear on there, and from there, we'll see the final result, and it should turn out nice. All right, stand by.
Alright, got the clear coat put on. Now as you can see, everything's enhanced, everything's brighter. When these, if you remember the video before, it shows, the design without the clear coat, but, you know, you can see that it's just so much brighter, everything's enhanced. These cups are always fun. If you have any more questions, just shoot a comment and I'll reply to them, and And watch out for some more videos. Please tune in. Please subscribe. Hit that like button. And hope you enjoy. Thank you.